Today, I'm in Spain, house hunting in and around the beautiful countryside and villages of inland Alicante. I'm Leah Charles King, and over the years, I've been involved in my family's property businesses, both in the UK and the Caribbean. Today, I'll be using all my skills to change the lives of father and son, Manuel and Marvin. And although our first family squabble is squashed...
I think this would be my bedroom.
Yeah.
That was an easy fight, Dad. You just let him have it.
Bigger than me.
They tend to rumble on.
Jade have to go.
I actually like the windows, and I think it adds to the character of the property.
So. Totally on your side with this one. Sorry, Dad. I visit this luxury property with jaw-dropping views of Alicante's famous mountain.
And, of course, the Mungo.
How cool to just have that sat here. Just be able to, it's like a work of art. It's beautiful.
Yes.
Nature at its finest, isn't it? But at the end of the day, do I manage to find my house hunters their perfect place in the sun?
I'm lost for words, actually. It's absolutely beautiful. This is exactly what, you know, I'd pictured.
Well impressed. Well done.
Ah, yes. Manuel first visited Spain over 50 years ago when he was just 12 years old. Since then, he's been back here a lot, including bringing his own children here for family holidays. Now, with son Marvin all grown up, they decided to join forces and find the perfect family holiday home that they can all enjoy. Manuel and Marvin both live in Cardiff. They work together in property refurbishment and management.
Yeah, we're a very close family.
Close-knit family.
As a whole, and Marvin and I being partners in business as well. If you didn't know who we were, you would think we were just mates.
If I had to describe my dad as a person, I would describe him as a role model, somebody that I look up to and aspire to be.
And he always answers my phone call.
And I don't answer many phone calls.
As well as Marvin, Manuel and his wife have a daughter, and Marvin has two girls. They can't wait to find a holiday home to enjoy with the whole family and think Alicante is the perfect place.
Very green there, nice people, and the beaches there. But certainly that province is just something about it, to be honest with you.
It's not just for us to buy for just us. Mm. It's for all our family to enjoy.
Everyone will have a set of keys.
Yeah.
They have a budget of £130,000 for their holiday home. Found right in the middle of the Costa Blanca, Alicante is one of the most popular tourist destinations in all of Spain. And direct flights to its airport take under 3 hours from the UK. While most visitors head straight for the 120 miles of sandy beaches, there are treasures to be found inland here too. Traditional villages and towns like Agost and Monover are nestled in amongst rolling countryside and are filled with streets lined with cafes and restaurants. And for the history buff, there's loads here too, with castles and pretty domed churches aplenty. In this part of Spain, a three-bedroom villa with a pool near the coast starts from £300,000. But if you decide to drive 20 minutes inland to a lovely town like La Romana, for example, then prices drop by half, which means I'm looking forward to showing Manuel and Marvin some great options. I'm meeting up with them to find out exactly what they're after. Good morning, Manuel and Marvin. Welcome back to Spain.
Morning.
Good morning.
How are you feeling to be back? You love this place.
Yeah, very, very excited. Yeah.
It's a home from home, to be honest with you.
Yeah. It's a joint venture then. You go 50-50 with this.
Yeah.
So let's talk about the dream then. You come out here, what are the type of things that you like doing when you're on your Spanish holidays?
Relaxing, that's priority. Mm-hmm. I do like a bit of fishing. And I do like my food.
So for myself, it's the beach. So me and my partner love the beach and my daughters.
But we do like our gardening.
Does the property need to come with a garden then?
I think at least we're potential for a garden.
So let's talk about the property itself. What type of property are you looking for?
So we're looking for a three-bedroom villa. Something with a bit of character, a pool, or at least potential to put a pool in.
How far are you willing to drive to the beach then?
Well, I think around about 40 minutes.
Okay. You guys are in the renovation business, right?
Yeah.
So you're not shy of doing a bit of work on the property if you have
not
to?
No. We can fit kitchens and fit bathrooms and...
Brilliant. You've got the skills.
Well, yeah, hopefully, yeah.
Well, he's got the skills. I'm just the labourer, so...
Well, then together, that's what makes
together
it work,
we'll make
the dream team.
Exactly. Yeah.
So, that big wish list, but the budget is £130,000. Any wiggle room?
We could possibly go up to 150.
OK, that's good. Now, if I find you somewhere that's just a little bit over budget, but I think it could be the perfect home for you and all the family, would you be willing to look at it?
Yeah, we would be willing to look at that.
For the sake of a couple of K, let's say, we wouldn't let it go.
All right, you ready to get cracking?
Yeah.
Let's go, guys.
Brilliant.
Let's go.
We're kicking off the search in La Romana, a village about half an hour's drive inland. Around 2,000 people live here, and 95% of them are Spanish. So it feels like a really traditional place with a weekly Saturday market. Surrounding the village is beautiful countryside filled with almond orchards and vineyards. So, gentlemen, we are in La Romana, aren't we?
Yes, I love it.
In the wonderful square here. Marvin, is this your first time here?
Yeah, this is my first time.
Right. But, Dad, you're very familiar with it.
Yeah. The wife and I visited this town quite a few times.
Did you know, though, that there's a local pool here, community pool, that opens up in the summer?
Oh, right.
That would be quite nice for the family, like a nice little day out as well.
Absolutely. Yeah.
This is what I sort of pictured. A very, very charming, very quintessential Spanish town.
So then the first property I'm taking you to see is just on the outskirts of town. We're talking about a 5 to 10 minute drive, if that.
Sounds good.
Yeah, ideal.
All right.
Sounds good.
Yeah. Let's head off.
Let's go.
Although these inland villages are cheaper than the coast, many are seeing steep rises in property prices, with those in La Romana increasing almost 17% in just the last year. So I've had to start with an option that maxes out their top budget, but it delivers on everything and more on their wish list. How is this for a first property?
Lovely. Very nice.
It's huge.
Yes.
It is, yeah.
Absolutely.
Yeah, very nice. Absolutely
lovely.
Stunning views. These are the views that we're looking for.
Picture perfect. Postcard.
So, first of all, we're on 4.5 acres of land.
Yeah, wow.
As you notice, though, there isn't a pool.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
But there's plenty of space
absolutely.
To put one in.
Yeah. I'll be frank as well. I think it's going to need a considerable amount of time to get an established garden here.
Yeah. I was thinking, a good idea, maybe a great way to start, is by sectioning off parts.
Yeah.
It's certainly a blank canvas.
Yeah.
And it's certainly something that we could work with.
You've got 3 bedrooms in there, 2 bathrooms.
Wow.
So it's on the market for just over £160,500.
Okay.
Now, I know that's over the budget, but the reason why I'm showing you is because the agent has told me that actually they're willing to negotiate to around £142,000.
Right, okay.
So that's a big drop.
Yeah, that's a good price, yeah.
All right, well, let's see if I could keep on impressing you then by taking you inside.
Let's have a look.
Follow me. This villa sits in those 4.5 acres of land, complete with garage. There's a covered terrace to the front, leading onto an open-plan living dining room and a good-sized kitchen with its own utility. The main bedroom has an ensuite shower room. Continuing on the same level are 2 more double bedrooms and a family bathroom. How is this for a living dining space?
Spacious. Yeah, very nice indeed.
I'm just thinking, would it be too small? Yeah, just in case the two families were over here at the same time.
What are the chances of you all being indoors at once, sitting on the sofa? We're in Spain!
That's a good point. I think there'd probably be nobody in the house, actually.
Well, yeah.
Do you know? That would be the irony, isn't it? Everyone would be outside. There's 4.5 acres out there.
Yeah.
So in terms of the decor, is this your type? Do you feel like it needs a bit of work?
Me, and I think my husband's the same, redecoration.
Yeah, what would you do? No, you'd go white.
Yeah, white. Yeah, keep it simple.
Should we go and have a look at the kitchen?
Yeah.
Come on through.
This is lovely. Good size.
It's
nice
it
size
is,
kitchen.
Isn't it? Really good size, I think.
Yeah. It is a good size.
Mm.
And I like the shape of it as well.
Yeah.
Yeah, it's definitely a nice flow.
Mm. What do you think of the actual kitchen suite itself?
I would change it. It'd be a gloss. Something in here, I think it'd be a gloss finish.
This is the main bedroom.
Yeah, this is it's definitely a nice size. Very good size.
Yeah.
I think this would be my bedroom.
That was an easy fight, Dad. You just let him have it.
Bigger than me.
Go up and see the rest of the property, and I'll meet you back in a bit.
Oh,
park.
Cheers.
Enjoy. Okay, so they both seem suitably impressed, but I've got a feeling that they're going to tell me that there's room for improvement. We'll soon find out.
Well, it's a nice size.
It's not bad, is it?
Nice size room. Good for the kids.
I mean, you could have bunk beds and
bed. Yeah.
You know, and we're both squeezing everything in. And this would be perfect in the winter.
Yeah. I mean, it could be used as another room as well.
Yeah.
If there's a few of us over here, a few of us could be in here as well.
Yeah.
I think it's got potential. I just don't know if it's the right one for
us. Yeah.
This villa with 4.5 acres of land and 3 bedrooms is on the market for just over a negotiable £160,500. They did seem to like it, but there was a lot they felt needed changing, so how does it fare overall?
It's got potential there.
Yeah.
You know, but I can't feel it, to be honest with you.
I feel it from you, Manuel. I can feel it. Go on then, Marvin, do you agree with Dad?
Yeah, I do agree with him. Just not for us.
Just not for us.
That's fine.
Yeah.
So then how could I improve? Tell me.
I think something with a pool, possibly.
Okay, yeah.
Actually installed. Maybe a bit smaller on the landscaping side of it, garden side of it.
Something there's a bit more sort of ready-made, ready to go, really.
Okay. Yeah. Fair enough. I'll take all of that on board. I've got somewhere in mind. I've always got somewhere in mind. Shall we head there?
Yeah, let's go.
Follow me, let's go. For my next option, we're taking a 20-minute drive north to the larger town of Monivher. It's filled with history, like its 18th century Gothic clock tower, and has lots of museums celebrating its culture and traditions. It's also a 40-minute drive from somewhere I think Manuel would fall hook, line and sinker for. So, gents, I thought I'd bring you here to El Bosquet Fishing Club. What do you think of it?
That's lovely.
Love it.
What is it that you get out of, well, just sitting there and trying to catch a fish?
It's just a relaxing day, you know, and it is a day, you know, you make a day of it.
Marvin, are you into this like your dad, or is it not your thing?
It's not really my thing. We've been sea fishing a couple of times, and I didn't catch anything. I think I caught a bit of seaweed. And that was pretty much it.
Do you know, it just costs £6 a day for a pass.
Oh, wow.
Yeah.
Well, that is excellent, that.
All right, well, let's go off, go see that property. Because we've got lots to do.
Yeah.
Coming up, if it's a pool that Manuel and Marvin are after, I think they're going to love taking a dip into my next property. Today, I'm in Spain with father and son, Manuel and Marvin, helping them find their dream holiday home in and around the beautiful countryside of inland Alicante. And I'll be honest, it hasn't gotten off to a great start, but I've still got 4 more chances to impress them. This pair, who work in property renovations together, are looking for a holiday home to share with their whole family and have a combined maximum budget of £150,000. They thought our first option had potential but just didn't have the right feeling and wanted somewhere a little more ready to go and with a pool. So we've come close to the town of Monivher for our second option. Prices are about 15% cheaper than in our last location, as foreign buyers haven't really discovered it yet. And houses tend to stay for longer on the market, meaning there's more scope for negotiation. So, property number 2, how are you feeling?
Good.
Yeah, good. Yeah. You know, this has definitely just got a good feel. It's got a lot of character. You can tell straight from the off.
Nice looking house from what I can see so far, and an established garden.
This, in my opinion, is a lot more manageable. I just think there are loads of little areas here for the kids, for the family as well to hang out. And also, there's a pool.
Oh, wow.
Right, okay.
Great. Well, that's definitely an improvement. But if there's something already there, it takes a stress.
It's more effort then internally then.
Yeah.
Exactly. You know? Getting to know you guys, you're going to want to go in there, you're going to want to update that certain things.
Yeah.
You're not afraid of that, are you?
Walk in the park.
But what you are looking at is a 5-bedroom property.
Oh, wow.
Yeah.
Wow.
And it's on for just under £143,000.
Right.
That's okay.
Yeah, that's a good price. Yeah. For a 5-bedroom property, that's reasonable.
My mind's ticking over already.
Oh, really? Yeah. Come on then, let's get going. I'm excited about this one. As well as that pool, terraces wrap around the entire property with lots of areas for eating and relaxing. And there's just over half an acre of garden too, with mountain views and a garage. Inside feels traditional with a dining room. That's open plan with the living room. And there's a separate kitchen. On the ground floor are three bedrooms and a toilet. Then upstairs is a built-on extension which is accessed via an external staircase. Up here are a further two bedrooms and a shower room. Come on in, guys. So this is the main family space.
It's a good size, actually. This.
Very nice size. And it's a fair size table, so yeah. This would probably be about the size of the table that we would have in here.
Yeah.
We would like sort of declutter a little bit, just put our own stamp on it. It's definitely an improvement.
Yeah.
I mean, all those windows with the gorgeous wooden shutters as well.
Yeah, yeah, that's a nice feature.
They'd have to go.
You don't like them, they're so traditional.
No.
Marvin, what do you think?
I like
gorgeous.
I actually like the windows, and I think it adds to the character of the property.
So. Totally on your side with this one. Sorry, Dad.
Yeah.
You like the shutters, yeah?
Yeah.
Keep the shutters, but I'll change the windows.
Okay.
Come on in. This is a good-sized kitchen, in my opinion, but there's a lot going on.
Yeah, this is amazing.
Look at that.
Yeah, a lot going on.
But what would you do with it?
Again, decoration, new kitchen, new tiles.
Yeah, a little breakfast bar by here.
Yeah,
it's a good size. I like it.
Yeah, I mean, this I would definitely keep that. That would be going nowhere.
So what do you think of this outdoor space? You've got more dining area for you and the family to sit. You've got more garden area that way. But of course, here's the piece de resistance. It's the pool that you're after.
Yeah, I think the grandkids would be happy with that, and the girls. Yeah. It's a nice sized pool.
And the view from there, looking out to the mountains.
Isn't it great?
Yeah,
it's beautiful,
Very nice.
Well, you're smiling away, which I'm pleased about. Go and look at the rest.
Yeah.
And we'll talk about it afterwards.
Great.
Enjoy. Yes! They're smiling, which means they're happy, which means I'm happy, which also means this could be in the running.
Yeah, quite a small bathroom. You could possibly knock in. This could be maybe an ensuite.
Yeah.
Or that'll make one of the rooms a bit bigger.
Okay.
Yeah, so it's an okay size.
Yeah.
You don't see anywhere where you can put wardrobes or...
No.
I'm not sure about the separate access
outside, you mean?
Outside.
Yeah.
This villa with a pool and five bedrooms is on the market for just under £143,000. They like the proportions inside, and the pool, outside space, and views all hit the right mark, too. But how did the rest go down?
Loved the gardens, disappointed with the extension.
Oh, no.
You've got to go outside and go upstairs.
Yeah. And
I can't get my head around that, to be honest with you.
I don't think it would be a contender. I just don't think that, that extension really works with the property.
I'm not going to lie, I'm a bit shocked. I really thought this was in the running. What can I show you next, then?
Similar size gardens and a bit more modern as well.
Love all the little nooks and crannies. We think that's great.
All right, I do have somewhere in mind. That might be a little bit more modern, but hopefully it will still have some features that you will fall in love with.
Yeah.
So we'll head there now?
Yeah.
All right, then. Come on, guys. Say goodbye to all these flowers and the nice pool. Another one bites the dust. I really want to impress these two, so next we're staying close to Monova as the location and outlook seem to be working for them. We're heading to an option just 2 miles from the town, which has all the modern conveniences Manuel and Marvin could need nestled in amongst historic buildings. As gardening seems to be an important factor on this search, there's a centre under an hour away I think they're going to love. What do you think of this place?
Oh, amazing.
Brilliant.
Amazing.
Yeah, great. Love it. Spend hours and a lot of money in here.
I bet.
You know, already I've seen some ideas in my head just looking down the bottom there.
Have you?
Like some of the water features there, natural stone.
All right, let's head to the next property. I hope you like it, and I really do hope this has given you some inspiration.
Yeah, absolutely, yeah.
If it's something more modern, yet still full of character that Marvin and Manuel are after, then I'm hoping they're going to love this little white house, which I think could be right up their street. Today, I'm house hunting in inland Alicante with father and son team, Manuel and Marvin, helping them find the dream holiday home that all the family can enjoy. We've already seen two properties, which unfortunately they didn't like, but I'm hoping my next will be right up their street. They work in property management and renovation together, so despite seeing the potential of both options, neither quite worked for them and their top budget of £150,000. We've stayed in Monaver for our third property, but headed more to the east of town. Prices here are a little cheaper than in our last location, as it's less well connected. But what this means is we're able to find something finished to a much higher spec for their budget. Righty-ho, here we are. Welcome to the Little White House.
Yeah, it's very pretty.
Very green, loved the view as soon as you came up.
So this, what we're about to see, is a three-bedroom property, and you've got a pool.
Great.
Right.
The only thing I would say would be that the property just looks a little small from the outside, but looks can be deceiving, so I'll hold judgment for now.
And it's on for the same price as the previous property that we saw, just under £143,000.
OK. Right, OK. Mm-hmm. Within budget?
Yeah.
Yeah.
Let's get in. I have high hopes for this one. The one-level house sits in 130 square metres of land with terraces, a garden and a covered swimming pool. There's a small porchway to the front, leading to an open-plan dining-living room. There's a separate kitchen, three double bedrooms, one with an ensuite shower room and a second shower room. Come on in and tell me what you think.
Yeah, this is lovely. It's a good space. From the initial first impression from the outside, it feels a lot bigger.
It's well proportioned. I'm liking it.
And I love the natural wooden beams there.
Excellent.
And the shutters.
Yeah. Another win for us, right? Yeah. I mean, we like the shutters, don't we?
I love them.
Actually, these look a bit more modern, to be honest with you.
Yeah, fair play.
Than the last one. I tell you, it looks a bit modern without being too ultra-modern.
Good. Well, look, let's go and check out the kitchen because I know you love a kitchen. Mm-hmm. Come on. What do you reckon?
Yeah, I think it's a good size. I would probably get rid of this wall. I don't think it's a load-bearing wall, so I think we could really open this up.
Yeah.
Maybe an island, kitchen island in the middle.
Perfect.
And the light from the lounge area, the dining area, and this. Yeah.
All flowing through. It could be pretty amazing, couldn't it?
Yeah, absolutely.
Happy with it?
Yeah, very.
Potential.
Yeah.
Come into the pool house. What do you think of it?
Yeah, I love the pool. The pool is really nice. I'm not too sure about this. I would probably remove this. Mm-hmm. I just think just take advantage of the lovely views here.
The owner has said if you do want to get rid of it, he'll absorb the cost or deduct that in the negotiations and he'll get rid of it.
Right.
Okay.
Okay then, guys, go and have a look at the rest of the property then, and we'll catch up in a bit.
Okay, great.
Thanks.
Well, that's going rather well. I'm very pleased, actually, because between you and me, I was a little bit worried after showing them the first two properties that they didn't like. But this one, I think this could be a contender.
Oh, this is a nice size.
It's a good size, this one.
Yeah, this is really good.
Look at this, nice windows.
Yeah, nice size bathroom. Yeah, very nice.
It's good choices, actually. Yeah, I like it. Yeah.
Great.
Okay, yeah.
This white house with three bedrooms is priced at just under £143,000. It seemed a bit small from the outside, but they were impressed with the finish and proportions inside. Could we have our first contender? How was viewing the rest of the house?
Yeah, it was really good.
Nice.
Took a look at the bedrooms and nice big bedroom.
It's deceiving.
It is deceiving. Yeah, it is.
Tell me something I want to hear. Is it a contender?
Yeah, it is. Yeah.
Do you agree, Marvin?
Yeah, I definitely think it's a contender.
So I have got two more chances to really get this right. How could I do that for the next one?
Well, maybe pushing the boat out a bit far. Extra bedroom, maybe.
Possibly something more manicured.
Okay.
But I'm clutching at straws, to be fair, so...
Okay.
We're very happy with this, very happy.
Brilliant. Mm-hmm. Okay, I've got an idea for the next spot. Let's go. For our fourth property, we're taking a 30-minute drive east to Agost, a town 400 metres above sea level and just under half an hour's drive from Alicante. It's fairly built up with lots of shops and restaurants, yet it still feels traditional, with historic buildings, and it's known locally for its production of pottery and ceramics. We're stopping off to soak it all in. How is this for a mountain view? Look at all of this.
Absolutely stunning.
What a view.
So yeah. This is the viewing point of this town called Agost. And you can see the church there. You can see Alicante going all the way that way.
What a place.
Yeah.
It's just absolutely stunning. The whole family would love this.
It would. It's always good to learn of local history and culture. So obviously this place is steeped in history. So it'd be great to learn more about that.
I've still got two more properties to show you and I'm hoping I'm going to nail it with the next one. Ready?
Let's go.
Come on then. Agost is a bit of a hidden gem when it comes to property, and demand in this area has actually been decreasing over the past couple of years, possibly because of its slightly more remote and mountainous location. By pushing Manuel and Marvin's budget here ever so slightly, I've been able to find them a completely different option, but one I hope they'll absolutely love. Oh, I'm so excited to show you this property. Welcome. What do you think, just by just looking at everything you can see around you?
Well, I'm lost for words, actually. It's absolutely beautiful. This is exactly what, you know, I'd pictured.
What do you think, Manuel?
Love it.
Do you?
Yeah. And the view.
Stunning. I mean...
Yeah.
360-degree views, pretty much. It's just going all the way around.
Well impressed. Well done.
Ah, yes. Yeah. So let me tell you about the property. I haven't even told you anything yet.
Yeah.
So as you can see, you've got your pool. We'll get that out of the way.
Yeah.
Good pool?
Beautiful pool.
Just the right size.
But let me tell you about the property itself. You've got four bedrooms in there.
Wow. Right.
See all this land, all these olive trees?
Right.
That would be yours.
Wow.
And let me tell you about this. The farmers maintain this. They make olive oil from it. And you get a cut of just under £1,000 a year for doing absolutely nothing.
Wow.
Okay. Oh,
that's great. That's great.
Ain't that brilliant?
That is brilliant. Yeah, because I didn't think this belonged to us.
Oh, it does. Do you know something else that belongs to you? Another two-bedroom casita up there. A whole separate house up there.
Is it?
A whole separate house.
Wow.
But what I will tell you is it needs doing up. You could do that in your sleep, you two.
Yeah.
I could see your brain ticking real well.
Yeah, that's amazing. I'm definitely getting the feeling.
I'm getting the feeling as well. It's not even me.
Yeah.
I'm getting the feeling for you. Okay. It's on the market for just over £156,000.
Okay.
So at the top end of the wiggle room, £6,000 over. How do you feel about that?
With an extra casita there as well. I think that's really good value. Yeah.
So go off. I'm not coming with you. I want you to go and explore everywhere yourselves. All right?
Thank you, Leah.
Enjoy. You. Off you go. Thanks. See you later. I am super duper happy to show Manuel and Marvin this property. They've already got the feels. I've got the feels for them. And I think this could be numero uno. This property sits in a huge plot of 12,000 square meters, which includes that land with olive groves. Outside terraces which wrap around the property, complete with an outside kitchen and that pool they loved. In the main house is an open plan living dining room and kitchen, and there are two downstairs bedrooms and a shower room. Upstairs are two more double bedrooms and a toilet, as well as a roof terrace. Then, in the separate standalone casita, or small house, there's a living dining room and two double bedrooms. Manuel and Marvin are starting in the main house.
All right.
It's very nice.
Yeah, it's cottagey. Yeah, I like it. I think we'd have to brighten it up, though, man, because it's a small room. You've got small windows. You'll have to put a bit of a brighter colour in here, and it'll pop then, you know. All right. Okay.
Yeah, it's a little bit on the small side.
But you can still get a double bed, as long as you can get in both sides.
The ceiling is quite high, actually, so that does give it just a feeling of space.
Yeah.
So.
That's nice, isn't it?
Yeah,
that
sounds great.
Yeah, a little summer kitchen there. Yeah. You've got the paella dishes, you know, cooking in the pool. Everybody's happy. Yeah, I like this, yeah.
This is amazing.
You've got a nice view up there and over there. You've got a nice view, haven't you?
Yeah.
Huh. All right, cool.
Yes, this is really nice. Yeah. Love the open fire there. I think I'll stay in this place.
Yeah.
This house in the mountains with a separate casita has a total of 6 bedrooms and is priced slightly over budget at just over £156,000. There's so much on offer for them here, and I can really see it working for their whole family. I hope they agree.
Oh, it's amazing. I mean, it just suits us right down to the ground.
It's exactly what we
pictured.
Yeah. And the added bonus, let's call it that, at the top there, that was great because that is just a blank canvas. You know, the clogs were going.
So much potential,
Think? Up there. Yeah. It's perfect.
Lost for words.
Yeah.
Oh, wow. Just giving the feels.
It definitely is.
Tell me then, is this a contender?
This is definitely a contender.
In fact, number one.
Well, I'm so pleased you like it. And now we've got 2 in the running, this one at the top spot. So I've got 1 more roll at the dice.
Top this, I'd be very surprised.
Well, let's see if I can surprise you then.
Yeah.
All right, come on, tear yourselves away from this place. Coming up, do I manage to surpass their expectations and find another option they love?
I mean, the views are stunning.
Yeah.
But a football pitch for the grandkids and man.
Which is pretty cool to have your own football pitch. I mean, come on. Today, I'm house hunting in inland Alicante, helping father and son, Marvin and Manuel, find their dream holiday home for all of the family. Now, I'll be honest, we didn't get off to a good start, but I'm happy to say I've now got 2 in the running and 1 more chance to really impress. This pair work in the renovation and property management business together, so they're old hands at seeing the potential of properties. Which they certainly could at our current favourite, this 4-bed mountain house in Agost, which had a pool, land, and this separate 2-bed casita. Also in the running is this 3-bed white house in Monova, where they love the views and proportions inside. I have 1 more chance to impress, and I'm hoping to do just that with this 4-bed villa with fantastic countryside views. But before that, I've got time for a quick treat of my own. A private tour around this luxury villa on the market for almost £3 million. Outside living is the order of the day here, with a lovely private pool backed by lots of al fresco dining areas and a great outside kitchen. Inside feels homely with warm furnishings across its living areas and 8 bedrooms. Agent Sana is showing me around.
So look at this grand entrance. This is a traditional finca style.
I'm loving this central staircase.
It's amazing, isn't it?
It's
fantastic.
And all this light. Yeah. Are these original beams as well?
Yes, this was open. This was a courtyard, but they closed it up and now you have this grand entrance.
I love what they've done. It's fantastic. So where can we see next?
But maybe we can go to the kitchen first.
Perfect.
So this is the kitchen.
I like this. And although, you know, it is a modern kitchen, I love the fact that it lends itself so well with the rest of the property and the interior. It complements it.
Yes, what you can see is that they made a mix between the old traditional materials such as the Tosca stone and the material which they use for the curtains. It was originally used to dry grapes here in this area.
I love that, and I love the arch as well. It just gives a kitchen like this character.
I agree.
Ah, cozy.
Yes, it is. This is the winter living room. Here you will be in the colder months. You can enjoy the fireplace.
I love this fireplace, and I take it it's that same traditional Tosca stone that we've seen in the kitchen.
Yes, and this creates this warm, cozy feeling in this living room.
Yeah, very romantic as well.
Yes. So look at the view.
Wow, this is nice. I like this because you're overlooking the pool. All the outdoor dining.
All this green.
Yeah.
And of course the Mungo.
How cool to just have that sat here and just be able to, it's like a work of art. It's beautiful.
Yes.
Nature at its finest, isn't it?
It's true.
Yeah. And do you know what? I could stay here all day, but unfortunately I've got to get back to work.
Well, it was a pleasure having you. Let me show you out.
Thank you, Sana. I'm sure Marvin and Manuel could have stayed there all day too, but I'm hoping they'll feel the same about our final option. It's back near the pretty countryside village of La Romana. Although it's almost 30 miles inland, I know Marvin, in particular, is a huge beach fan. So before heading there, I wanted to swing by one of the best here, Santa Pola. What do you think of this one?
Yeah, it's absolutely beautiful. Loads of palm trees, just a nice vibe here.
What do you love doing when you're down on the beach?
Well, usually just a bit of sunbathing, a bit of snorkeling.
It's more about the grandkids on the beach with me, you know, keeping them happy. It looks like a friendly place and it's well maintained as well. You know? I like it.
And the good news is that the final property is about 40 minutes in the car.
Right, okay.
I'm happy with that, yeah.
All right then, ready for that fifth and final property?
Yep.
Come on then, let's go. La Romana, in particular, is becoming a popular spot amongst foreign buyers, and there are lots of British, Dutch and Belgian owners here. To try and blow them away, I'm showing them something over their top budget of £150,000. But it is negotiable, and there's so much on offer here for the whole family. This is it, gentlemen, the fifth and final one.
First impressions, I do like the house.
I really like it.
Certainly the exterior looks a bit more modern than the last one.
It was built in the 90s, so it's actually not that old.
I mean, the views are stunning.
Yeah.
But a football pitch for the grandkids and Marvin.
Which is pretty cool to have your own football pitch. I mean, come on. You've got a swimming pool up there.
Okay.
Now, inside the property itself, it lends itself to 4 bedrooms. 2 bathrooms. It's on the market for just over £165,500.
Okay.
Now, I'm bringing you here, though, because the owner has said that he'd be willing to negotiate.
I think if we could come up, they could come down, maybe we could meet at the middle.
OK, well, let's have a look at this first, then.
Yeah.
I think we've got to take it from there, man.
Yeah,
definitely.
OK, all right, then. Shall we get inside?
Let's go,
Let's do this.
Thank you.
This villa sits in a plot of almost 5,000 square metres, with that swimming pool at the back, football pitch, mature gardens, and an outbuilding and a garage. Wrapping around the property is a covered veranda. Inside is a large kitchen diner, which leads through to a second kitchen and a living room. All on the one level are 3 double bedrooms, one with an ensuite shower, a 4th single currently used for storage, and a 2nd shower room. Take in your family country style kitchen.
Okay.
Personally, what I'd do, I'd get rid of that kitchen. The living room is on the other side. I'd open that all up and just make that big family space. Mm. And in terms of in here though, what do you think of this space?
Yeah, I love this space. Loads of character, love the beams. I wouldn't want to paint. I like the colour of the walls,
so
I wouldn't really
cool,
want to paint, the walls.
Yeah, it's nice. It is nice. Mm.
Yep, just through that way into here. So this is the family living room.
Yeah, I like it. Love the wood burner there.
Yeah,
of course.
It's a little bit small.
It is a bit small, but obviously there's the kitchen there.
Like you said, you know, you don't need 2 kitchens, and just open this up, yeah?
Yeah, I'm liking it.
Here we go with the pool.
That's lovely. Nice-sized pool.
It's not bad, is it?
Yeah.
And the views as well from the pool.
Yeah, they're stunning.
Yeah, lovely.
Ideally located.
And well elevated as well.
Mm. And you see beyond this wall, this whole patch there. That's also comes with the property.
That's proof. I was hoping you'd say
that. Yeah.
There's so much potential.
You want to see the rest, obviously. So go off and do that, and then we'll get down to it at the end. I'll find out if this could be also in the running.
Okay.
Cheers. Enjoy.
Thanks.
See ya.
Wow, this is a big size.
It's
nice
a good
size
bedroom now. Got loads of room here.
Loads of closet space there.
Nice
size ensuite. Yeah, I think the inside of this property flows better. It's bigger than the mountain property.
Yeah.
This house with 2 kitchens and 4 bedrooms is on the market for just over a negotiable £165,500. They love the views, and I think it once again got their renovator cogs spinning. Do we have another contender? Tell me everything, I'm waiting.
Yeah, we really like it. And the practicality, the views. We just we do like this type of property. I mean, it's different from the mountain house, but just offers so much potential.
So where do we stand? Because when we last spoke, obviously the little white house with the covered pool, that was in the running. What's happened to that now?
That's gone.
Fine.
Yeah.
No problem.
We've narrowed it down to two.
The two is obviously the mountain house, and then
this one.
Yeah, I'm still having trouble getting the mountain house out of my head.
Don't envy being in your position tonight, deciding what you're going to do. Shall we catch up in the morning?
Yeah great.
Yeah? All right. If you'd like more information on any of the properties featured on today's show, go to aplaceinthesun.com/programmes. I've now shown Manuel and Marvin all five properties around inland Alicante for their top budget of £150,000. We've been trying to find a holiday home that can work for their whole family, so I'm thrilled we have two contenders. Our final property went down a storm with its great views, pool and potential. But they also couldn't get this house with amazing outdoor space in the mountains in August out of their minds. Now they've had some time to consult with their wives and families back home. Has a decision been made? Good morning.
Good morning.
Manuel, Marvin, how was last night?
Yeah, it was difficult. Yeah, it was.
So when I left you yesterday, there were two properties in the running. What did everyone have to say?
Yeah, so we spoke with the family. I mean, the mountain house just instantly got that vibe, got that feeling.
Marvin loved the mountain house, and I certainly, at that stage, loved the mountain house. But in reality, like, we sort of looked at, you know, the practicality, the distance from the town.
You know, that isolation, I think, the girls couldn't get over.
It was too big an issue, wasn't it?
It's just literally the location.
That one now is out, then?
Yeah.
Yeah, that one is out, yeah.
So then we're left with the house with the two kitchens, which you did love.
Yeah, we'd like to make an offer on that one.
You would.
Yeah, we had a good think about it. I think that's the one.
I think it was the location, but also the potential.
Okay, so we know that was on the market for just over £165,500. Now, the agent did indicate that the owners would be willing to negotiate. They didn't indicate by how much, but we're hoping that we can meet somewhere in the middle, right?
Yeah.
How much would you like to put in an offer for?
I think we want to start it off. Mm-hmm. When 4-3, we decided. We've come to that figure basically on three things. Mm-hmm. No air conditioning, it needs new kitchen. And we'd have to knock the second kitchen into the lounge.
All right. Let me give the agent a call then. Hola, hello there, Raphael. It's Leah calling. I've got some great news for you because Manuel and Marvin, they would love to put in an offer. So the issue is, though, is that there is a bit of work to do in the property. So the offer that they would like to put in is for £143,000. Fantastic. Thank you so much, Raphael. Speak to you soon. Hopefully he'll call us back any minute.
Yeah.
Nerve-wracking, isn't it?
Yeah.
So what's your plan B? Oh!
That frightened me.
Maybe I'm never going to find out what it is. Hi, Raphael. Right. OK. Well, thank you for letting me know, and I'll pass this on. Wow. I'm actually a bit stunned. It's not good news, I'm afraid.
OK.
Raphael just said he spoke to the owner. Obviously, that offer was too low, so he would have rejected it anyway. But after we saw that property yesterday, they had another viewing.
What? Right.
And another offer was put in just a couple of grand below the asking price.
Right.
And the owner looks like he's gone with it.
Yeah. Well, yeah. It is what it is. you can't do enough about it. Yeah.
I mean, do you want to put in a higher offer? Do you think you can, or...?
It would be stretching a bit too far, gutted.
Yeah, really disappointed. Yeah.
I am so disappointed for you.
If it's meant to be, it's meant to be.
Yeah, it's a motivator. Yeah. You know, we've got that feeling and of sort of being so close to a property, and that's just going to motivate us even more.
Look, I'm sorry it's ended this way. I want to shed a tear myself. I'm trying to. So, you know what? Let's, at this point, I just want to raise a glass to you and your family and just say, your dream home is out here. Here's to you guys. And when you get it, you better invite me round for a barbecue.
Leah.
100%. The family.
To the family. Thank you, Leah.
A few weeks later, Manuel and Marvin returned to Spain with their wives and viewed several more properties. They found a townhouse they loved, and I'm very pleased to say that they sealed the deal. I'm sure they'll have great times ahead with their very own place in the sun.